okay?
Yeah. Another?
Yes, we had you. You talk about micro enterprise and you'll continue. Micro enterprise in green economy, no?
Yeah, exactly.
Please, 30 minutes, please.
Shall I share my slides from my side? I'm just sharing my slides.
No.
You click the share screen. Click the share screen on the bottom.
Yeah. Is this visible?
Okay.
Now you press F5. Yes. Right.
This is
all. So, good afternoon to all of you. This is Dr. Yogesh Sinhane from Bandra University of Agriculture and Technology, Bandra, situated in Uttar Pradesh, India. We are just talking about green economy and microeconomics today.
Excuse me. You can stay near the phone, please, or there is a bell.
Okay. It's clear. It's clear now.
Yes.
Yeah. So, focusing on four points. What is mean by what is a green economy? The second one is what is a micro enterprise? The role of forest in a green economy, and why forest important for green economy? These are the main sectors we are discussing in this lecture. Actually, I am coming from forest department and department of forest product in this inner city of the Bandra. So, as we know, the green economy importance in the current scenario. Everybody is trying to develop their businesses with, getting some money or established to do something with this environment. But the most important thing is the green economy is also the resultant part in that. So the human well-being is a social equity while significantly reducing environmental risk to get ecological sacrifices. So in other words, we are just discussing here and that a green economy is one whose growth of income and a job is driven by investment that reduce carbon emissions and pollution, enhance efficiency and sustain biodiversity and ecosystem services. If you are thinking about microeconomics, before that we are just think about green economy, which is totally depend upon environment and the outer the carbon emission, pollution and different things which is related to this many micro enterprises which is situated especially on a forest area. As we know the need, as we know what is a basic need of this green economy and why we are just thinking about green economy, that is the main important part here. It was the born out of multiple crises and accelerating resource scarcity. A green economy is the economic vehicle for sustainable development. And it is also a part of the persistence of poverty. It is a new economic paradigm that can drive growth of income and jobs without creating environmental risk. every time we are just focusing about environmental enhancement with this green economy to sustain or to enhance, especially the enterprise of the micro enterprise, especially based on forest sectors and allied sector of the agriculture even. Green economy in action, as per the UNDP results, I just put the Asia, China, Indonesia, Japan data here, and Republic Korea even I just put here. In that 23% of the global green stimulus investment is happening in that. In China, we are just focusing, they're just focusing about $468 billion in green key sector by 2015. And they are just trying to doubling it in the past 5 years. In Indonesia also, the National Development Plan has a goal, green and enhancing Indonesia in 2025, a 7-41 target, 70% gross domestic product increasing and a 41% greenhouse gas reduction by 2030. And Japan also 3 R's, that is reduce, reuse and recycle of the waste minimization policy is also happened in that. The Republic of Korea has a Green New Deal policy of 2% of GDP invested in green growth. What is the key findings in green economy? The investing in natural capital, resource and energy efficiency can lead to, first is a higher rate of GDP growth over time and enhanced wealth. Second one is the natural capital stock. Third one is the reduced poverty. And fourth one is the decent environment. I just put one image here. It shows how it's looked up to 2050. Urban land also getting enhanced with green economy. Then the grazing land also helpful. Crop land, that is agriculture, and the forest land. The each and everything combining, and the combination of this each and every sector, we will get a great micro enterprises with this green economy. The examples of the green employment, as we know about, main sector is agriculture. Many people are involved all over the world in agriculture, and allied sector of the agriculture is forest and fisheries and everything, animal husbandry. And the agriculture over the next decades, global employment could increase by as much as 4% in the last 5 years. Forest conservation and reforestation could boost formal employment by 20%. In future, and the transport improved energy efficiency across all transport modes. It is combined with modal shift to increase employment by about 10% above business as usual. The energy sector is the most influencing sector in that time. We are just focusing about solar energy and different natural energies. We are just trying to develop technology with these natural energies like water energy, air energy, like sunlight. We are just utilizing as a great source of the sun to transport that energy for employment, that is 20% higher than businesses as usual by 2050, while delivering a robust economic growth and reduced emissions. Here, I just put one example of the coal production, oil production, gas production, biofuel, thermal power, the real energy power and energy efficiency. The whole things are going to be come under the green economy, and help of that green economy, we can just reduce the dependability of the coal production, oil production, gas production, and all. So next is enabling of the green economy's innovative and imaginative public policies. Here we are just discussing about the regulatory frameworks, capacity building training, taxation, smart market mechanisms, international governance. These are the main priorities of the green investment when we try to establish any micro enterprises with this help of this green economy and collaboration with nature, with environment especially. The financing is the most important part if you start any kind of business or any kind of micro enterprises. In that, the investments in the range of $1.3 trillion a year, less than the cost is more abundant. Exact cost to the 1/10 of the total investment in a physical capital. Investment in green sectors is growing. Investment in clean energy, also the sharing the same data in 2020, it's reported by UNDP, and importance of the smart public policy to leverage private capital, the need for the innovative mechanism. This key finding, a green economy, statements growth and exceeds due over the time. 2010, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 2040, 2045, 2050. As we saw in a result before, the same data, you can easily find out the fluctuations with years. If you're trying to utilize a green energy with environment safety and environment protection, we can easily conquer the things what was happened in the past, and we are just thinking about future. So we're just focusing about present with green economy, it will be very beneficial. While reducing the economical scarcities and environmental risk, that is main important part in the up to 2050. It's real GDP, GDP capita, energy demand, water demand, forest land, utilization in the sector, in the forest land, and the footprinting biocapacity is the main things in this reducing ecological scarcities. Forest and the green economy. As we know, the forest is a main important part to store carbon dioxide, and it provides, it's locked by carbon, help of the wood. We are using wood, means we are just indirectly or directly using wood, means we are just using carbon, because wood is the main sector to lock carbon. Help of this green economy, we are just focusing about the forest and what is the main role of the forest in green economy. I'm just trying to focusing in that. And the forests are a critical link in the transition to a green economy. The International Year of Forest, as we know, 2011, and the World Environment Day also is celebrated already. In that, we conclude main three things in this 2011. The International Forest Year, that is government, civil society, and businesses to promote forest as a critical contribution to a green economic transition via sustainable management, forest conservation, and payment schemes. Forest in a green economy, what is the role of the forest in a green economy? It provides the roadmap for greening the forest sector that will contribute to the discourse in the lead up to 2020, sets out options for policymakers. It will provide options for the policymaker to reduce the burden, actual burden. It will help of this sector, the forest sector. They examines the conditions for significantly increasing investment in a forest and underlying goods and services for the forest provided. Why forest? The forest generate income and provide employment. It was the most important thing in that. The forest provide nutrition, reducing vulnerability and diminishing energy scarcity. Trends in deforestation and simultaneous networks are almighty high of the plantation due to plantation. The current approach to management of forest in a frontier approach is the main important thing. We are thinking forest with this green economy and micro enterprises also. A green economy, the most important part of the forest is public and private investment is a main part in the catalyzed support by the targeted policy reforms, regulation changes, and capacity building. Forests are managed and invested in as an asset class are important factors of the production. International mechanisms increase investment in a forest. Forest management hinges critically on an effective and transparent accounting system. These are the four main important parts if you collaborate forest in a green economy. The investment of forest sector with green economy, as we compare forestry with this green economy, then we just think about the money. Because in micro enterprises or macro enterprises, the money is the most important part. If you can't generate money, it means you can't generate your business and you can't run your business. That is the main important part. How, if you are successful to generate money by any sector of this forestry, especially in a green economy. So we will focusing on this, $40 billion US dollar is required to have global deforestation by 2030 and increasing reforestation and afforestation by 140% by 2050, related to business as usual. As we saw in a graph, everybody can easily mention, easily identify the deforestation reduction under the green economy scenario, the G20 NFEAO. The investments in the forest sector, that is targeted investment in the forest could generate about 10 million new jobs. The main important part, 10 million new jobs create in the future. Most of these increase occurs via an increase in the small and medium-sized enterprises. It will directly or indirectly help for this small and medium-sized enterprises. In the forest sector, 80 to 90% of the enterprises are small and medium-sized. Due to that, it will help for the a rural area, for the mountain areas, for this those people have not having great opportunities. It will directly or indirectly helpful due to this. In 80 to 90% of the enterprise are small and medium sized based on this forest sector, especially. Then small and micro businesses has currently provided more than 50% of the forest sector employment in many countries. Enabling condition is what? The role of the international community. As we know, REDD plus scheme is also available. The generate knowledge of the forest ecosystem services also. Stimulate the engagement from the commercial financial sector. Reinvestment income from royalties and taxes into the forest sector also. The enabling conditions to the role of the government. Everywhere, the role of the government is the most important part. If you trying to establish any policy, the main part is that is government or the role of the government. That is guarantee adequate returns on the risk adjustment investment. First, second one is the device transparent and efficient procedures. Then agree on a national vision for ways and means which of the forest can contribute to government. Then the employ market based instruments to promote green investment and innovation also. Enabling conditions, as we continue with the enabling conditions, the role of the business and financial institutions. The investing in forest project, many forest projects given by IFRO, given by ITO, given by CIFOR, given by FAO, many organizations are trying to give the good projects, which is based on forest, forest related micro enterprises. So, I to establish such kind of
I think there is a problem.
Yeah, he is disconnected. Please wait a while. Let me tell you, the area from where he is speaking is one of the most remote area in India. It lies in central India. It's called a Bundelkhand region, which is quite remote, and the place is the town where he is really a very small town with very scarce facilities and infrastructure. So it's great that at least he appeared. So we should wait and have a patience, please.
We shall continue with the others' presentations. So if Dr. Sumtane is coming back, he will be in the last of the session. So if you agree, Dr. Om Kartel is here present.
Yes, Professor Dan, I'm here.